Already so pretty in the parking lot.
Yep.
Guys, he's trying something.
Finally here.
Sandwich time.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
Yes, another weekend, another hiking day.
Correct. And we are back again in Mount Hood Wilderness. It feels so good to be back here.
Yeah.
Especially during the summers, because we wanted to do some hike in the summers for the first time in Mount Hood, and this is our first opportunity. Although it's a little cloudy here, but regardless, it still feels good to be back here. And we are super excited to go on one of the amazing hikes. This time it leads to one of the greatest waterfalls here in Mount Hood. It's called the Ramona Falls. It's not too much of a difficult hike. We'll show you on our way, and hopefully you can gather how the hike is going to be if you are planning to go off on it yourself. Unfortunately, we parked a little before the trailhead without realizing that there was a parking spot here. Now the only job is to figure out where the trail starts. It's pretty.
But the views are already so pretty in the parking lot.
Yep, it looks amazing. So open and amazing. Alright, so as you can see, there are two trails here, Sandy River Trail and the Ramona Falls. Ramona Falls is about 3.5 miles in and 3.5 miles out, with a meager elevation gain of about 1000 feet or so. So let's do this. What intrigues you?
There's some note about crossing glacial streams.
Alright.
Do we have to?
Oh, I guess I don't know. We'll have a first hand experience ourselves. I see a lot of people carrying camping bags. Maybe it's a good camping place. On our way to the Ramona Falls trailhead, there are a lot of campgrounds, so it's a great opportunity for campers. There are a couple of good or famous campgrounds here, like the McNeil River Crossing Safety on Glacial Streams. Interesting. So guys, it turns out that you need to get a permit starting May 15 to October 15 if you want to go on this trail, or I believe any other trail nearby this area. And so you need to pull out a permit from that box over here. You also have a pencil, but carry your own pen if you have, and fill it out before heading up.
Looks like a pretty less trafficked trail. You know, memories from my last weekend hike, which was the... What was the last weekend hike? Right. Which was the Saddle Mountain hike. Man, there was a lot of competition. Little bit of a trivia for you guys, which was our first hike in the Mount Hood forest area. I love the hikes which are not high elevation. I hope you know that by now about me. If you don't, you need to subscribe to Forever Hum and watch all our hiking videos and other videos as well. And follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Terms and conditions apply.
So the paths are a little trickier, so it can be a little hard to identify which way to go. What is one thing that you love about this hike, this particular hike?
It's very open. I have been a little bored of staying under the canopy of deep forests.
Well, there's forest here as well.
Yes, but it's very open. You can see the creek or river, and you can see the top of the mountains, which are covered with forest. It's a good hike. Okay guys, something happened this morning that has made my day. In fact, it has made my year. So we were parking our car, and this very sweet lady came up to us and said, "We recognize you. I have seen one of your videos of Angel's Rest." I was like, oh. I was so happy. And they were happy too.
That was a complete fangirl moment. It's quite soothing to hear the sound of the river or the creek along your hike. At a vista point, I suppose.
body breathe.
Yep, totally. Nice. So here we go. Down to the creek. Pretty nice hike, I must say. So far at least.
Guys, we are having trouble deciding how to cross this glacial stream. Guys, he's trying something. Let's see what he's up to. Looks like climbing that shaky, bouncy tree is the only way we can rescue ourselves. So guys, Deepak has found this truly innovative way of crossing the stream. Everybody else is climbing on that tree there, but Deepak found a new way.
Well, it wasn't new, it was kind of lying around here.
So after crossing the river, I'm finally back out in the open. Where the split starts. So we'll head out this way and we'll go all the way and then come from that side, which is part of the Pacific Crest Trail. And who does not know about Pacific Crest Trail?
I don't, please tell me.
Alright, it's actually one of the biggest and the longest trails in Northern America. It starts all the way from Southern California and ends up all the way till Canada.
Right, I'm so ready for it.
You ready for it?
Yes.
It's like doing the Appalachian Trail. And that's like one of the biggest or longest hikes on the East Coast. But reminding of the East Coast Appalachian Trail,
we have a bunch of hiking videos in the East Coast when we were spending some time there during lockdown last year. So check them out.
Yes. So Sonia has finally learned to carry a backpack. This part of the trail resembles the coast, kind of like Saddle Mountain or Cape Falcon.
Look at that monkey dancing. Not really, but he might start dancing anytime soon and hurt his knee again. That's the kind of thing monkeys do. Deepak, tell people the answer to the trivia question, which was our first hike in the Mount Hood National Forest area.
Hint. Mountain.
Hey, what was that?
Bald mountain.
Oh wow. You should play dumb charades. Literally when he first did zzzz. Now I was like, he's gone crazy again. But then it made sense to me.
I'm not the one who goes crazy. You're the one who goes crazy.
Yeah, sure. So guys, Deepak answered this correctly. If you haven't checked out our Bald Mountain hike, you should do that right away because it was honestly a great hike. We did have a lot of hurdles at the time. We had to cross fallen trees and everything, but it was totally worth it. We'll put the video somewhere above, so do check that out.
The intersection point. Ramona Falls that way, I believe it's like 400 feet. Ooh, you can actually go to the Timberline Lodge if you keep going along the Pacific Crest Trail. approaching slowly and steadily. Oh look, this patch of ice.
Good thing it's not on the trail.
Again, patches of ice here. Look at that woman over there. There it is. Wow. I want to see her reaction. How it is?
This is multiple.
I know, that's what makes this special.
Level.
Exactly. Wow, it's like
in a hotel or something.
I know. Finally here. Look at that beauty. Okay, guess what time it is? Sandwich time! In front of Ramona Falls. Wow, such a pretty view. And yet, she is not even ashamed. She's not offering me. This part of the hike is really beautiful, guys. So make sure that you go on this trail as well, either while coming or while going. So lush green. It's really serene. So guys, this part of the trail has some really good spots where you can stop and take some photos, and like it has a different kind of vibe here.
Yeah, I really love those tiny bridges made out of wood. Yeah,
it's beautiful. It's really nice. We totally recommend you that you check this part of the trail out and you complete that loop, because this is where it gets really exciting and pretty.
And we didn't find a lot of people on this particular part of the trail. Since we've left the Ramona Falls, maybe it's not that explored as the other leg, but it's certainly pretty. So yeah, definitely check it out. Oh, looks like these trees have been cut down to build this bridge, which is so unique. It's so pretty.
Okay guys, so it's that time of the day again, crossing the stream. Oh, I do see that the water level has gone up a little bit. I guess it's harder for the taller person, and he seems to be progressing really fast. Thank you.
close to the point where we got the permit at the parking lot, and we made it in 3 hours 46 minutes. That's including the lunch time or the snack time and taking photographs at Ramona Falls. So officially it's 7.9 miles, well, a little less than 7.9, and 1100 feet. And I see a lot of crowd now. So how do you want to rate this hike?
10 on 10.
Oh, wow.
One of the issues that come up repeatedly after hiking is that high elevation. I tend to get really tired after a high elevation hike, and this was just the perfect elevation for me, and the views were so gorgeous.
But somehow you managed to break your legs even on this hike.
Yes, okay, I was about to come to that. I managed to twist my ankle almost 8 to 10 times. That's just because there are big rocks on the trail, so be careful of that. But still, maybe because of that I can take off half a mark. So 9.5 out of 10.
But that's your fault. Why would you blame the hike?
Okay, so 10 on 10. So, right. In a sense, guys, do try this hike out. It's really a must do.
Both of us personally liked it so much that we would probably end up coming here again sometime during midsummer. The weather is going to be even more fantastic. Like, it's going to be bright and sunny. And meanwhile, we'd like you to try it out yourself and let us know how you see this hike from your perspective.
And watch our other hiking videos if you haven't already, because we have quite a few on our channel.
Yep, and we have so many hikes from Mount Hood or from Oregon coast as well.
Yeah,
so
we have you all ready for the summer season in Oregon.
Hell yeah. Before we leave, you know what to do. Do the need full.
Yes, because it really means a lot to us. Subscribe to our channel. Comment below the video and let us know how you found this video. And press the bell icon to get instant notifications from our channel.
We'll see you in the next video. Bye.